I won't get mixed up.
Damn!
What the?
Will you leave me be?
Why, you cocksucker!
Thank you.
know just the place. Always heading into that refinery.
There's an old rundown shack just over the border, north of a place called Dewberry Creek. Leave it hidden somewhere near there.
Hello.
I think I caught you at a bad time.
Just don't play games, Arthur.
I ain't.
I hear you saved Mr. Bell from a hanging.
I'm sorry.
Well, I suppose he'd do the same for you.
Exactly.
We're all in this together, Mr. Morgan. I know you know that.
Of course, Miss Grimshaw.
Hey, son. Cheer up.
God, I need a drink.
Okay.
You heard me.
I'm already leaving.
You consider this a warning.
Move as fast as I can.
Char is just too much fun.
Yeah, keep going.
Girl.
God damn it! Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see. Mrs. Linton, a caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been... you've been made a widow and you come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Ah, okay.
My family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but... but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me? Please, Arthur. I know it's a lot to ask. I can see you haven't changed much.
Mary.
You, mister, excuse me.
Morning.
Out of the damn way.
Morning.
Arthur!
Welcome back.
That was some ride, girl.
Morning, Arthur.
Well, whatever else is in store for us, Arthur, I'll tell you one thing.
What's that?
The rare old pleasure not to be freezing our balls off up in those mountains.
You're not wrong there.
Be well.
And you, Hosea.
Good morning, Arthur.
Why are you following me?
So, a feller in town recognized me from Blackwater.
That's not good.
It's okay, though. I dealt with it.
Hey, Arthur!
What do you want?
Uncle told me something about a train.
What did he say?
Mary Beth overheard something about a train full of wealthy folk rolling down through Scarlet Meadows just south of the state border.
Yes.
Need help with it?
I ain't even sure about doing it.
Come on. At night, not too guarded, it's perfect.
Nah, I ain't thought it through. You know, stopping a train, pain in the ass.
Sure, but what if we could force a train to stop?
Well, of course.
We get a wagon full of something flammable, oil. Put it on the tracks. They see it. They know they either have to stop or die. Ain't no train driver wants to be cooked alive.
That is kind of brilliant. For you. That is a real idea. I think that's the first time you ever had one of them.
Shut up.
You might be the first bastard to ever have half his brains eaten by a wolf and end up more intelligent.
So we're doing it?
Yeah, we're gonna need ammunition, guns, look real frightening, and some dynamite to open up the train.
I'll get the supplies. Gotta head into town for Abigail anyway. Don't even ask. Go find us an oil wagon.